Louisiana shit. Murder on the beat. Something for y'all to cut up to, you know? Yeah.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I thought I'd do something a little bit different with you guys, because literally so many of you guys have asked for me to do a car tour, and my car honestly is one of my favorite things in the entire world, so I thought why not share it with you guys. So as you guys would have already seen, my car is a Mini One, and it was registered in June 2017, so it's pretty new and it is my baby. Honestly, I love it. So because my car was a brand new car, I was really lucky that I got to actually choose the features that it has and the spec that it has inside. So I'm going to take you through step by step everything that my car has inside of it. So let's turn you guys around and get started. Okay guys, so to begin with, this is the steering wheel. So it has a leather steering wheel, and it's got these function buttons on it which help you to change things like your music. So this is to make phone calls, these are the volume buttons for your music, and these are menu buttons so that you can change the song while you're driving and things like that. And then on this side we've got cruise control, so you press that one in the middle and it puts the car into cruise control. And then you can put a limiter on it as well, so if say you're in a 30 mile per hour speed zone, you can put a 30 mile per hour limit on it so that you don't get flashed by a camera, which is really good. And then you just use these to either increase your speed or lower your speed. But to be honest, the only time I ever really use that is, like I say, is if I'm going through a zone where there is a speed limit and I want to make sure that I definitely don't go over it, or I use it on the motorway because it's really handy when you're driving on the motorway for ages. So bringing you guys in a little bit more, this is the speedometer, so it just shows me how fast I'm going. And then you can also see things like the time, the temperature. You can flick through these as well, so it shows you different things. So it's showing you that the engine's cold because the engine's not on. And then you can flick through, it shows you things like your mileage. So this car obviously has just over 5,000 miles on it. Girl, you need to get some petrol. Look at that. That shows you how much petrol you've got left. And then if you can see, we've got the indicators here. And then on the other side, those are my lights. So if I bring you guys over to the center, you can see this screen. Now, I think you can only get this installed in Mini models after 2014, but honestly, it's such a good little computer. So I'll show you guys how it works. So it's got controls all the way down here. So this is the menu. This is media, radio, telephone, and sat nav. And then we've got options, and then this is like a little mouse, so you use that to scroll. So if I press menu, I'm going to show you guys what it does. So then here you guys can see the main menu. So the first thing on the menu is the sat nav. So if I just click onto that and show you guys, so you get the sat nav added in as an extra to this car. So I think it cost me about an extra £1,600. Obviously it is a lot of money, but you've got to remember that cars are expensive and they are an investment. So I made a choice to get this sat nav put into this car because I knew that it would definitely benefit me for the years that I have to come with this car. So if I scroll down and find somewhere to go to, so if I said, let's say that we're going to Brighton in East Sussex, and then I start the guidance and it just starts working out which way I should go. I just felt like I definitely needed a sat nav in this car, otherwise I was just gonna spend my whole life getting lost. So yeah, that has definitely saved my life a few times, especially when I have to travel up to London to go to the hospital. And then I'm just gonna take it back to the menu, and then I'm gonna go on to vehicle information. And on here you can check the vehicle status. I thought this was honestly so cool, just because it measures the tire pressure as you drive along, and I honestly find that so helpful because when it comes to things like that, I'm so rubbish. I always forget to check things like that. And then if you go up, it tells you about any service requirements. So my engine oil's good, my brake fluid's good. I don't need a vehicle inspection or a check, which is all good. And also when you're sat still, you can actually measure the engine oil level, which I think is cool as well. Again, it just makes life a little bit easier. It saves you from having to pop the bonnet, go and check the oil. It's just easy. You can just get in the car and check it. And then if I go back to the menu, I'm gonna move along to my contacts. This is so cool, obviously, because of the fact that it just helps you out like when you're driving along, how many times have you needed to make a phone call? And you can connect your phone and you can scroll through your music by artist, by song, by playlist. It's just such a quick and easy way of changing your music, which is so essential to me, because honestly, I change my mind about what song to have on all the time. Like, is it just me who gets halfway through a song and then it makes you think of another song and then you can't stop thinking about the other song, so then you have to change it? Well, it might just be me, but that happens to me all the time. So then just being able to literally just scroll through using the mouse is so helpful, because the way that Mini have designed this mouse, you can do it whilst you're driving along. It makes it so easy and it just stops you from getting distracted, really, which is so good. I am a sensible driver. I've never had any accidents. I am a very cautious driver. We all know how easy it is to get distracted, and having a car that caters to the fact that you are going to want to change your music, you are going to want to make phone calls whilst you're driving at some point, it just makes it so much safer, and I just think it's so important. And then last on the menu is the radio. So then you obviously just get DAB and all of the AM and FM channels. So then I'm gonna move you guys down. So down here in this section, we've got the air conditioning. So you have climate control on both sides, which is honestly so great for me and Mark, because I'm always freezing cold and he's always boiling hot. So you can have it different temperatures, no arguments, great. And then as an extra, I did add heated seats. So on both sides, I do have heated seats, which have three different heat options, like that. They are honestly so warm and maybe one of my favourite features in the entire car, honestly. On cold days, my heated seats literally save my life. I love them so much. And then down here, you can just see all of the usual features, like the ones to demist your windows and things like that. And then this little start-stop button down here is how you actually start the engine. So this is a keyless car, so you don't actually have to put the key in anywhere when you get in. You just have to have the key on your person. So if it's in my bag, that'll be fine. Then you just come in, hold the clutch down and press this button and it starts the car. And then obviously down here you've got like a charger port and things like that, and then an aux cable, but you don't really need that in this car. Oh, by the way guys, I really wanted to show you this feature. It is a really small feature, but honestly it's the little things that sell the car to me, because when I first heard about this I was like, sold, I'm having it. So basically you can change the color of the lights around the screen. Can have a nice little blue, a purple, a pink. But yeah, I love that feature. I always think that's pretty cool. And then by my gear stick, you can see that I do drive a manual. I would literally never get an automatic, just because I spent so much time working hard, learning how to drive manual. Like, I just don't want to throw it away by getting an automatic car and then forget how to drive a manual car. It would just irritate me so much. So I just always get manual. In a Mini, you don't actually have the frame around the window, which I find is really, really nice. So look. Mini windows are kind of built like a convertible. They don't attach at the top, which I really like. So with Minis, they are only four seats, as you guys can see, so they are pretty small. Also guys, when it comes to Minis, people literally always forget that there are only four seats, but that is very important to remember, because just like the name says, they are Mini, they are tiny. So I think Minis are only really practical if you are quite small. Mark absolutely hates driving anywhere in this car. Like, even in the passenger seat, he just complains so much that he never has enough leg room. So I wouldn't recommend getting a Mini if you're particularly tall. I knew that the car that I wanted would be a Mini. And when I was well enough, I worked really, really hard to get this car. And even though after I got the car, my health got a lot worse, I'm still really pleased that I got it. It's honestly the biggest treat that I've ever bought myself. And it cheers me up when I'm having a bad day, or if I've had a bad day of reactions. Sometimes in the evening when I feel a bit better, I just go out for a drive, just because it cheers me up.
So guys, I was thinking it wouldn't really be a car tour without a walk around of the outside, so I wanted to show you guys my alloys that I got on this car. Once I realized that I was getting the gray color, I just knew that I needed the black alloys to go with it, because to be honest, I had seen some other Minis with the black alloys and I just thought it just looks so nice with the gray. They were about £600 on top of the original price of the car. Although they were expensive, I have found that they were definitely worth it, only because I haven't scratched them at all and they look so shiny when they're clean. They're just so nice. So yeah, this is honestly my favorite color of this car ever, and now you guys can see how good the black alloys look with them. also show you what I meant about the windows as well. So when you open the door, see, it's not like attached to anything, which I think is really nice. It's the small things. And then I'll show you guys the boot as well. It's a pretty good size boot for a mini, to be honest, because you do get, just excuse my messiness, but you do get two parts to the boot. So when you actually have this part of the boot up, can you see like that? It's actually quite a big boot.
So guys, that is the end of my car tour. I really hope that you guys like my car, and I really, really hope that you guys enjoy this video because you did ask for it. Don't forget to smash a big thumbs up down below for me. Thank you guys again for watching this video, and I'll see you guys next time.